Hallelujah, hallelujah, hallelujah. Today the Lord revealed one wonderful and magnificent things to me. The Lord was saying to me, my ways are not your ways. It is not as you think that the Lord thinks. The Lord thinks differently from us. Hence, he wants us to understand some things of the heaven. Two of celestial songs was given to me. The first one is Kosho ko lo gbeje gbeje kaje ko lo gbeje gbeje okunkun ko lebo ri I mole kaye ko lo simi. Hence, it means that the witches and the wizards should keep still. They can darkness can never overcome light. Why? Because out of that darkness came forth the light. It is the Lord that came forth out of nothing. He always brings something good out of nothing. Hence, he said, my ways, the ways of God are mysterious to accomplish his work. His ways no man can determine. No man can determine. Unsearchable they are. Man cannot determine the ways of the Lord. Hence, he said, the flesh profit nothing. The flesh profit nothing. When you are still in your manhood as a flesh, you cannot understand what the Spirit is saying. But the Spirit of the Lord understands everything. That is why he said the Spirit gives life, life in abundance. It gives you the understanding of who God is. Hence, we are very swift and quickly to quote Jeremiah 29:11. The Lord knows the thought I have for you is the thought of good and not of evil. Hence, we decided to change the will of God to suit our own purpose. Because your life is structured, because everything is working well for you, because your characters and your manners are acceptable by the word, does not determine that you are in the will of God for your life. The will of God is for you to accept every situation and circumstances according to how the Spirit of the Lord has led you. That is why he said, as much as are led by the Spirit of God, they are called the children of the Most High. He said, for this cause and for this purpose and for this reason have I raised Pharaoh, that I may destroy him and his all his entourage, that the world will know that I am God that is able to do anything, that I am mighty and power and powerful in every ways of my life. Hence, Christ has to relinquish every authority and power that he has got. How many people can dethrone themselves, can release what the Lord has given to them, or can deny themselves the joy and the goodness of this world to lay down their life for other peoples to live? No man. It is only by the Spirit and the power of God and enablement of power of God that you can achieve it. Our Lord Jesus Christ is the only and able candidate that could serve that purpose to prove to us that our ways are not his ways. As the heaven is as high to the earth, so is the ways of God concerning our own way. Everything we plan for. Okay, listen, children of God. God called Abraham out of his family. And the Lord said, I will not accommodate any divorce or separation, that a nation that divided against itself will not stand. Hence, he called Abraham out of his comfortable zone. He was well with his family and in harmony and happy and enjoying himself. He grew up within them. There is love that transpires within them. The light of God radiates around them. Everything was working out for him in the family. All of a sudden, the Lord called him. He said, come. Not for this purpose have I created you. We keep forgetting one thing in Psalm 100 verse 3. That the Lord created us for himself and for his own purpose and not our own purpose. Hence, we have designed what we want to achieve and do in life. Not what God wants us to do for his glory. That people will see what is happening to us and our life as it has been structured and said, it is only God that could have designed this. No man can ever do it. Hence, we tend to design our life the way we want. There are some things we are doing on the face of the earth that is not according to the will of God. Because it is acceptable to the world does not mean it is acceptable to God. The will of God must be good, must be something acceptable and something that is perfect. And nothing can be perfect unless it fills the purpose of God. Unless God is glorified in whatever, anything you are laying your hand upon, it does not mean that it is the will of God for your life. Search diligently for what the will of God is, the purpose of God for your life is. Hence, you will be able to walk according to the will and the purpose of God for your life. He called Abraham out of Ur, or of Chaldea, that come out of your brethren, come out of your comfortable zone. I have created you to showcase you to the world that you have to walk with me by faith. It is not by sight, but by faith. You can be enjoying every situation and everything working out for you today, and you are praying and you are binding and you are losing and things are working for you. Listen, children of God. Listen, brethren in the Lord. It does not mean it is the purpose of God for your life. It does not mean that is the will of God. You search what is the will of God for your life. Abraham left his kindred even when he was comfortable and happy. And the Lord said, I will show you a place where your generation... God wants us to expand. He wants the whole earth to be filled with his glory. That is his mission. And he will do everything accordingly. We raised animals and fowls and chicken and all that. And we raise them for a purpose. Why do we raise them? God has created us for a purpose. And we need to serve and do his purpose in our life. If we do not walk according to the will of God in our life, ladies and gentlemen, I have news for you. Sorry, I am very sorry. It will not work. You need to walk according to even if you are not comfortable or it suits you, even if the world did not accept it, it is the will and the purpose of God. It needs to be obeyed and walk in line with. Walk in line with the will of God for your life. Search. Not what people accept, not people wanted, but what the Lord will be glorified about. He created Pharaoh for his own glory, to destroy him, that people will know that it is not by power or by might, but by my spirit, saith the Lord. He destroyed Pharaoh and all his chariot. Everything Pharaoh has sank in that Red Sea, just for the glory of God. Would you have prayed that you should be in position of Pharaoh? No. Would you have prayed to be in the position of Abraham, that the Lord separated him? Yes, you will say, because Abraham's blessings are mine, and the ways of Abraham is acceptable and it is good to you. Yes, it is the will of God, but there are some things Abraham did that is not according to the will and purpose of God for his life. But the end shall justify the means. At the hall of fame, Abraham's name was written there. Rahab's name was written there. Would you have prayed that your life should be like the life of those one that were taken out of darkness and become into the kingdom of light? No, we have structured our life. Hence, we tagged other people and we think these people are not fit. These people are not God. Good, but we are the best. Our ways are structured well. Look at me. Look at my family, my children, my grandchildren, my this and my that and my businesses. And No. The man that came to Christ and said to Christ, look, everything I have obeyed and I've done everything that suits the whole world. I have followed the law and people have known I'm a righteous man. But God saw him as unrighteous. Why? Because it is the righteousness of God in Christ that could make us righteous. We don't have a righteousness of our own. No matter how you structure your life, no matter how people celebrate you, no matter how people want to be like you, no matter what you do in life that edify yourself and the people and does not fulfill the will of God for your life, ladies and gentlemen, it is zero. Because we have to fulfill the purpose of God in our life. Lord Jesus Christ said to the man, go and sell all those things. Give away your family. Leave them and follow me. Leave everything that you think the world is celebrating concerning you. No, it is difficult for us nowadays. When we are told that, you will say, no, I know the thought of God for my life. The thought of, okay, children of God, we always look at the cake and the best part of the glory of God. And that is what we attach ourselves to. What about the one that will bring glory to his mighty name? What about the one that will showcase the magnitude of God for our life? Ladies and gentlemen, don't be fooled further. Know that whatever happens to you in life, as far as you continue to walk with the fear and the obedience of his word and his ways, believe, whether good or bad, everything works together for good for those that trust and believe in God. Nothing that comes to your life, as far as you are the chosen one of the Most High God, that is not for the purpose of God. It could be negativity, it could be sadness, it could be what you can call it on the face of the wall, of the house. I tell you, ladies and gentlemen, if you stand and you did not waver, you focus looking unto Jesus, the author and finisher of your faith, you will get to your destination when the Lord will showcase you and introduce you to the Father and say, these are the ones that you have given to me. None of them have lost except the son of perdition. Those that thought the world is about them. Everything concerning this world is about them. They live a perfect life. The living, that is the way God wants them to live. No, 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 no. Don't look down on people that are living reckless and useless life to you. It might be the purpose of God for their life. And when you can see them and say, God, I thank God for the life I'm living. I'm not like that person. It is not that you are better than them. We are all in the same boat. The boat of Noah that he created. All animals were there with different characters and different attitude and different motion and different motive of being on the face of the earth. And we all abide in the boat together. We are in these things together, all to the glory of God. Ladies and gentlemen, think twice before you look down on people. Think twice before you condemn others. Think twice before you say anything. That person might be walking in the will of God for their life. You might be walking contrary to the will of God for your life, because we tend to bind and loose. As a Christian, we said we want to be with our Father. And he said in John 14, it's from 1. He said, children of God, do not let your heart be troubled. Where I am going, I have prepared a place for you in my place. We get trouble for nothing's sake, for no reason. Until Peter comes to the understanding that, look, let the purpose of God and the will of God be done concerning my life. He was denying Christ, thinking, oh, why will I face this death because of this man? But it is that same man that faced death for you and I to live. He understand that concept. Hence, he said, I will preach the gospel, which is the foolishness unto man. Yes, when you are in the world, the gospel is a foolish thing to you, because all you want to hear is good news. Hey, the Lord bless you. I am happy in the Lord. It is well with my soul. Blessed be the name of the Lord. I am blessed with all spiritual blessing in heavenly places. As the Lord opened your eyes or your intuition to understand what spiritual blessing means, how to attain the spiritual blessing, obey the Lord in whatever situation. Can you deny yourself of your daily bread in obeying the Lord? If the Lord said to you, no, don't go to work today. No, the Lord will never say that. How do you know the heart of the Lord? Because you want to satisfy your own will. Everything we're doing on the face of the earth, 88% of it are our own will, not the will of God. Let the will of God prevail. Let the glory of God be manifest. Let people see God in us. Do not structure your life. God has not tailored our life the way we tailored it. We tailored our life because that is the way we want it. Ask God, how do you want me to live? What do you want me to do? How will your name be glorified? And follow what the Lord lays upon your heart. No matter how difficult it is, he said, I will be with you from now on to the end. He did not leave Christ. He did not deny Christ. And he showcased Christ. He glorified himself in Christ. Let God glorify himself in your life. All the people that their name were written in the hall of fame, Rahab will have thought that, Lord, if I have done this thing and done it against my nation, I deceived them. I deceived my nation. That is the way we will put it. I betrayed my nation. I did not follow the injunction of the king. But she knew that there is a king that is greater than the king that commanded her. And she followed her mind and what the Lord has laid proposal concerning her life. She betrayed every other things and hold on to the pillar of Christ. Hence, her name was written in the book of life. The same thing, Ruth. He went against every other protocol just for the glory of God to manifest in her life. And against him with Esther, he went again contrary to everything. He was a Jew. She was a Jew, not supposed to be with Cyrus. And she was with her, and she went with her, and she did everything contrary to what the law of the Jews says. But the Lord is walking through and in her. Ladies and gentlemen, out of a dead lion that is rotting, honey came forth out of it. It is out of darkness the light came. Hence, the darkness cannot comprehend light. That how did this happen through and in me? That is why the Lord said, the stone that was refused become the chief cornerstone of the house. It is the Lord's doing. It is marvelous in our eyes. This is the day which the Lord has made. We will rejoice and be glad in it. Live free life. Live free life. Don't be held bound by what the Lord has loosed you out of. The devil that comes to your life comes to kill, to steal, and to destroy. But the Lord has come to give you life, life in abundance. That life, life in abundance must not mean the one the world will celebrate, but it is the one that will showcase the glory of God. Anything that could not showcase the glory of God is null and void. Anything that will edify and magnify the glory of God, it is what the Lord has made. Whoever you are, no matter circumstances or situation you find yourself, whether you are condemned, you are a murderer, you are a rapist, a pedophile, a gay, no matter what the world has tagged you to be, ladies and gentlemen, I'm calling your attention to the will and purpose of God for your life. The Lord can open and will open a new book concerning you. Listen to His word. Read and meditate in His word and follow His commandment and instruction. Leave the world, leave the man in you, and let the spirit in you spring forth. It is the man that the lion that died, powerful and mighty thing that was killed, out of his carcass came honey. Honey will come out. Your spirit will come to life when you are dead to the world. But when you are still living in the world, sorry children and lovers of the world, you cannot inherit God. You cannot serve two God together. The world cannot be celebrating you as well as God celebrating you. You have to let go one and let the other one be celebrated. Let God be glorified in you and let the world reject you. It does not matter what they think or what they thought of you. It is what the Lord has taught concerning you. The Lord will be with you. It is the word of God that the Lord has revealed into my heart, and I thought I'd just share it with the ones that love the word of God. God will empower you. It will open your eyes to see beyond. Let the will of God prevail in our life. We come together in the name of the Lord. Let Him showcase Himself, not us showcasing ourselves. This is what I want. Forget about the title. Forget about what the world wants to give to you. Forget about how the world will think your life is perfect. It is not about the world. It is about God, and it's about Christ. May the peace and the power and the understanding of God rest upon each and every one of us. He said, I have given you peace, not as the world gives, but the peace that even when you have been crucified, denied and rejected for the name of God, you will still be fulfilled and happy. Let God be glad and you be man. Let Him be glorified. Let's give the King of Kings a shout of hallelujah and let us praise His name. For He is good. His mercies endureth forever. Amen. Thank you and thank you. God bless you all and have a wonderful day today. It is well. 14th of July, 2016. God be glorified in my life and use me for your glory in whatever form or way you want. And let people see your glory through and in me. In my fallen state, let those people that are coming behind learn from it. And in my joyous and glorious time, let them know that God still walks through and in each and every one of us, all for His glory and His purpose, in the name of Jesus Christ. Amen and amen and amen.